In this example, here a figure shows a small circular coil of area A suspended from a point O by a string of length L in a uniform magnetic induction B in the horizontal direction. Here it is saying if the coil is set into oscillations like a simple pendulum, by displacing it at a small angle theta naught, as we can see, we are required to find the induced EMF in the coil as a function of time. And we are also required to assume the plane of coil is always in the plane of the string. So in this situation, we can see when we release the coil, it will start oscillating like a pendulum, of which the angular frequency of oscillation omega, we know it is given as root of g by L. And time period will be 2 pi root of L by g. In this situation, if at t equal to 0, it is released. At any time, we can see the ring will be at a position making an angle theta with a vertical. And this angle theta, we can directly write by using the SHM equation. Here you can see after time t, this is at an instant t, the angular position of coil from vertical is, this can be given as theta is equals to theta naught cos of omega t. And from this expression, we can also find out the angular speed of rotation of this rod, that is d theta by dt. This can be given as theta naught omega sine of omega t. We can also put a negative sign by derivative. And this is denoting that in this situation, the coil is coming toward the mean position. It is just giving us the direction. And if we talk about at time t, magnetic flux through the coil, then this magnetic flux we can write as B dot A. The magnetic induction is toward right. And its area vector, we can say this will be in a direction perpendicular to its surface. If this angle is theta, the angle which area vector is making with the magnetic field vector is also theta. So this can be written as BA cos theta, which can be further written as BA cos of, in the situation the value of theta we can write as theta naught cos omega t. So it will be theta naught cos of root of g by lt. If we are required to find the magnetic flux as a function of time, this is the result. To find out the EMF induced in the rod, we can use Faraday's law. Let's continue on the next sheet. As we have seen, the magnetic flux passing through the coil is given as BA cos theta. We can write the EMF induced in coil is, this can be given as mod of d phi by dt, and on differentiating we are getting it as BA sin theta d theta by dt. And in this situation for small theta, we can write sin theta is approximately equal to theta. So in this situation, EMF induced can be written as BA theta d theta by dt. If we substitute the values, the EMF we are getting is BA. The value of theta is theta naught cos of root g by lt. And in this situation, d theta by dt we can write as we already calculated in magnitude, this theta naught omega sine of root of g by lt. Now in this situation, we can further simplify the result. The EMF here we can see cos root g by lt, sin root g by lt, we can write as 2 sin of 2 root lt by 2. So it will be half b a theta naught square omega sin of twice of root g by l into t. This will be the answer to a problem, that is the EMF induced in the coil as a function of time.